So I want to wrapping it up with a couple quick things. I wanted to bring up my dad because I did my mom thing. My dad was awesome, but like after three beers, I'd get kind of buzzed and nostalgic, and I'd call my dad and tell him how much I love him and what a great Little League coach he was. Two things. Me and my dad didn't get along very well, and two, he never coached Little League. He was banned the first season, first game of the season I ever played, and I was shitty, by the way. I was like a roving outfielder. They made a fourth outfield position for me just to kick dirt and chase butterflies. Like, God, I might as well have had the leg braces on, then there'd be an excuse. I was just pathetic and so maladroit now and as a child. But my dad got in a fist fight the first game, so they banned him from the field. So he would have to watch the games while sitting on the hood of his car, drinking Budweiser tall boys, like six, maybe 12 over a 2-hour game, and then drive me home. It was the 80s, no one cared. It was just like, yeah, okay, he's doing donuts over a hobo, that's probably good. So yeah, so my dad was like, so three beers, I call him and said, thank you so much, I love you. And then like six or seven beers, I call him like, I'll fight you anytime, any place, motherfucker. Meet me in Fresno by the train tracks, bring a bicycle chain, like, you know, like. That's the fight you pick your shirts off, and it's like Christmas. There's a Christmas tree in the window behind you. It's not even yours. There's fires burning, you know. And then at the end, he hugs you, and he's like, I like that essay you wrote about, you know, badgers in fourth grade or whatever. Shit. So, yeah, well, man, he was all right. Him and my mom divorced when I was in college because they're like trying to stay together until I left. And I was like, dude, get a fucking, when I was eight, I was like, you guys hate each other? Get a fucking divorce because then I get two Christmases. I get a Megatron and a bicycle. You motherfuckers, it's capitalism. Do it, you know? Do it. Might be able to get a jet ski someday, you fuckers. So they got divorced when I was in my 20s, and then my mom stayed single because all the guys are creepy and they got scary boners and all that. And my dad proceeded to marry a Hooters waitress who was like a size A who put like gigantic Orange County double D's into, which is just like, Dad, the only thing those are doing is messing up my cell phone signal and blocking a mammogram. Get those out. Get those out. They're so dangerous for everyone involved. And that was a match made in hell. That didn't work out. She had a drug problem my dad didn't know about. And she got arrested on a cruise ship. She got arrested on a cruise ship with methamphetamines on her. Do you know how fucking hard it is to get arrested on a cruise ship? They just want you drunk and in sandals and fucking spit. Like, they give you shotguns and booze and there's roulette. You have to cut a fuck. You know what I mean? You have to kidnap a baby and beat another baby to death to even get a stern talking to on a cruise ship. So that didn't work out. Divorced her, and I'm like, oh, good job, Dad. Maybe you should fucking get your shit together and, you know, not think with your dick like you're a jazz musician or whatever. But because he had two kids, and they're like, oh, fuck, that's gonna, oh, they're gonna be on America's Most Wanted. And then I'm gonna have to spring them, and I love them, and they're sweet. But you know what I mean? Like, oh, fuck, they're both gonna have stage names. Cocksuckers. It's sad, but it's fun. It's gonna be a good time. So that's yeah. So he had a second wife. That didn't work out. 10 years, kids. And then right at the end, he got married. My dad's final wife was a 23-year-old Chinese mail order bride that he stole from another man at an El Torito Grill restaurant by the John Wayne Airport in Orange County. Things about that. This is a true story. Some asshole from Oregon, like, flew some bitch in from China or whatever. I don't know if she's mail order, but it was definitely one of those websites. You know, the Russian chicks pop up on MySpace. It's one of those for Asian chicks, some fetish site. Ships her over in, like, some crate, probably like the leg lamp in A Christmas Story. Like, Fragile. Exactly. It's like Fragile. And then they open her up and they put her up in the thing and then. And they live in Oregon, and Oregon's got pretty shitty weather, so they come for like, oh, let's go on vacation, and they go to my hometown of Huntington Beach, California, which is like the most white trash, awful vacation. It's a great place to live and raise your kids, but there's nothing to fucking, it's like 20 minutes from Disneyland, and there's kids on meth skateboarding. That's all you can do. You can see UFC guys walk their pit bulls and their stripper girlfriends downtown, and that is all there is. There are three UFC training facilities on the main street of my hometown. The last library burned out in 1972. They never rebuilt it. True story. True story. So my dad steals this lady. This idiot goes, there's an El Torito girl by the airport. They fly in. My dad's there for like some business thing. The guy gets up to go to the bathroom. My dad sends the Chinese lady a Cadillac margarita. Yeah. Oh, $14, a classy one. Maybe a little side shot and all that. Swoops her up in the yellow Corvette, and they take off. And like 2 months later, they're living together. 6 months later, they're married. And just, he was like codependent. He wasn't raised. He was raised under a bridge where they used to like light owls on fire. Like, he told me, yeah, we used to get gasoline and go where the owls slept and like light them on fire and then kick them. Like, one of the most proudest, most beautiful animals, just on fire with little hobo children with bare feet kicking them. So it wasn't a perfect situation on anyone's part. So they're living together. They're married. And here's the thing about my dad. And it's hard to sell this to people, but you guys will get it. My dad is a Vietnam veteran. He fought in Vietnam for a year, got Purple Heart, all that shit, got blown up because he's alive, had all his limbs and all that shit. But the thing is, that being said, my dad was an incredible racist. But he was a fun racist because he fucking hated everyone. Like, my mom is Mexican, he hated Mexicans, his relatives are Polish, he hated Polacks. And he hated Asian people, he hated like Vietnamese people because they tried to kill him for a year with, you know, rockets and all that shit, so whatever. They're shooting at me in pajamas. No, that's horrible. So he hates Asians, but he hates all Asians because he can't tell them apart. He calls them all the G word, and you're like, oh fuck, you mean Russian? That's from Asia. I hate them too. Fuck, yeah, Jesus, Dad, not the same thing. So he's racist, but 6 months in, he gets married. Her whole family lived like in a city like in Alhambra or whatever. So on the weekends, I'd come drive down. My dad lived like an hour away. I would drive down to visit my dad once in a while, as much as I could, in front of the bicycle chain, ready to fight at all times. At all times. So I'd go down and walk into my father's home, and my dad would be there sitting in his like big recliner chair smoking with his own ashtray, and there would be like 18 of her Chinese relatives sitting in a semicircle around my father, all smoking Pall Malls in their own cigarette, in their own ashtrays, 19 ashtrays in the room, watching World Series of Poker on his 60-inch plasma screen TV. It was fucking creepy, and it's like around the McCain, you know, the elections last time. It was kind of like as if John McCain had gone to that POW camp, and when they're like, no, you're free to go, you know, they let him loose, he's like, no, I think I gotta stay here. I'll be running this motherfucker in 6 months. Hey, you know, like, my dad is POW King, basically. And that being said, like, because he fought in Vietnam, that was his answer to everything. He has his thing, like, anything I couldn't do. Oh, yeah? Oh, you don't know how to change a tire? You ever kill a man? I'm like, dude, I went to Christian school for 9 years. I'm pretty sure I wasn't supposed to kill a man. That was, like, in one of the commandments, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, well, maybe if you had, you wouldn't be such a little faggot and you know how to change a tire. Like, well, maybe if you hadn't, you wouldn't cry every time the song from MASH comes on TV.